Blog Talk Radio.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Presents Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast, playing your favorite acapella gospel songs from some of the world's greatest acapella artists. So sit back, relax, and listen to the sweet sounds of voices. Call in live to telephone 713-955-0508 or send us an email to srbutler1009@yahoo.com. So who's riding with Stevie B on the blast tonight? You're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Ladies and gentlemen, before I start the show, this is my first show back on the blast after about a month of illness, and I want to thank everybody for their prayers and their concern on behalf of my family and myself, and it really means a lot to me to know how much people really care, and we serve a good God who loves us and cares for us, and we just want to glorify Him, and that's what this is all about. Amen. This radio show is the 2018 nominee for the NACAMA, the National Academy Christian Acapella Music Award. This radio show is being broadcast from the great state of North Carolina. This is Stevie B, and I'm the Blaster Master of Acapella Gospel Music. And according to Yvonne, the General Connor from Dayton, Ohio, she says Stevie B is the hardest working Christian DJ in the world today. Bless her heart. And my dear brother Anthony Blunt, he's the radio host for the Gospel Train that airs on Sunday morning on 94.7 FM, WWBC 1510 AM in Rockledge, Florida. He said the same thing during our interview on his radio show. So it must be some truth to it. And my brother Ali Zell from Fayetteville, North Carolina, he said, Stevie B is the mouth of acapella gospel music. I like that. Okay, let me, this big iron bird on up off the ground, I saved my little coins and bought me a new airplane, ladies and gentlemen. Master, if you're not dropping any bombs on your radio show, I said boom boom. Ladies and gentlemen, we are taking back Friday night for the Lord. Oh, yes, we are. For the next 3 hours, I want to play some of your favorite acapella gospel songs from such artists as Straight Company, Dorian Paul, Commit Acapella Chorus, and many, many more. I want to hear from our listeners tonight. You can give me a call to the live show at 713-955-0508. Or you can send me your emails to my new email address at butlersteve1009@yahoo.com and let me know who's riding with me on the blast tonight. I'm trying to lift up your spirits with these inspirational songs on a Friday night. That's right. It's Friday night. And Stevie B is playing acapella gospel music. So turn up your spiritual
Stevie B's acapella gospel music blast.
At the bottom of the hour, I'll be playing my song of the week. Now, we want to feature a song, just tell you a little bit about the artist. And the song I'll be playing on the show tonight will get 3 plays on the show tonight. Now, that's my song of the week. We'll also be featuring my Funny Bones. You know, I love those comedians because laughter is good for the soul. I'll be featuring 3 comedians on the broadcast tonight. Also, I'll be featuring my shout outs. Now, these are just some people I want to that I've been in contact with here on social media and also in my local area. But due to this pandemic and this coronavirus, it has things hadn't been the same. I must admit, we have to distance ourselves and we just have to be careful and be safe. So, but I'm still meeting some good folks right outside of Fort Bragg, North Carolina, who are listening to this radio show, and they just love acapella gospel music. And a lot of people I've been meeting have never even heard of acapella gospel music. So it's just a thrill for me just to be able to introduce this great music to them that we get to enjoy here on the blast on a Friday night. So I'm just I just want to show them some love and just let them know how much I really do appreciate their support for this radio show. I also have a new feature on the broadcast, my monthly triple spin. And for the month of June, I will be featuring Testament Acapella Ensemble. Now, I started featuring them back in May, but when I got ill, so I'm just going to keep doing that group for the month of June since I only featured them for 1 week back in May. So that's my monthly triple spin. Also, we have a new feature, my O100s. Now, these are just some songs that's been around for quite some time, and some of these songs we're still singing in our congregations. So I just call them my O100s. And we also just want to honor some of these saints who started acapella gospel music that we love so much. So I also want to feature my listener's choice. Now, this is just a song my listeners told me they want to hear. So I just give them an opportunity to add a song to my playlist on a weekly basis. Now, we started a new promotion back in May, and at the bottom of the hour, we try to do this around 6:30 and 7:30. I'll be making 2 calls to our listeners on the show who sent them their phone numbers to the show, so we want to give them a call. We have some free gifts, free CDs we want to give away. My sponsors have agreed to give away some gifts. Yvonne Blazing Cracker Gooch from Nashville, Tennessee, and we're going to be making some calls on the broadcast tonight, so we're looking forward to that. So you got Stevie B loose in the booth on the ones and twos.
Stevie B's acapella gospel music blast.
On tonight's show, ladies and gentlemen, we have some new singles from Daryl Barnett, from Anissa Rebels, from Near Purpose, Daryl Smith, Called by God. I like saying that. Monte Cuba, Vision, Shannon, of course, and many, many more. We also have some new Funny Bones. Now, stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, for the month of June. We have 2 albums that we'll be debuting on the show. On June the 12th, we have Dwayne Pugh and Brad MacArthur from Dallas, Texas. They just released their new albums entitled Life and Music. So we are looking forward to having them on the broadcast on next week's show. So stay tuned for that. And then on June the 26th, I think that's the last Friday of this month of June, we have Anissa Rebels and her producer, Lewis Cooper from Dazelle Records in Memphis, Tennessee. Anissa has a new album that she just released on May the 1st entitled Stronghold, and we'll be debuting that album here on the broadcast as well. So stay tuned for those upcoming shows. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you know we try to do the Story Glory segment every first Friday of the month. We are having the artists that we actually play on this radio show, on the broadcast, so you can get a chance to know them and just learn about them. We always like to know who it is that we're listening to on this radio show. So on tonight's show, ladies and gentlemen, our special guest in the Story Glory segment is the Soul Influence from Houston, Texas. We have Marcus Barnum and Monte Cuba. How you brothers doing on the broadcast tonight?
Doing all right, my man.
Hey, certainly glad to have you. Who are we talking to here?
This is Cuba. This is Cuba. From Houston, Texas, and I'm glad, very glad to be on the show today.
Hey, brother, so glad to have you riding with us. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I know you are familiar with Monte Cuba. We've been playing him on this show for quite some time. We're certainly always grateful to have Monte on the broadcast. Marcus, you with us?
Yes, sir, I am. Thank you for having me.
Yes, sir, brother. Now, why don't Marcus? Let's start with you first. Why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself, Monte? I'm gonna go ahead and put you back in queue because I hear a lot of background
Cuba,
noise.
That must be your period window down. I
think.
That's my air conditioning problem. Yeah.
Okay.
There we go.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Okay, Marcus. You want to go ahead, Cuba? Let me go ahead and put you in queue because that might knock out some of this noise. Okay, yeah, that did it. Okay, Marcus Barnum, we have Marcus Barnum. You want to go ahead and introduce yourself to my listeners for those who might not be familiar with you and the group, The Soul Influence?
Sure. My name is Marcus Barnum from Houston, Texas. The Soul Influence, we've been together since 1999. We've been doing it along. God has been blessing us, and we like to think that people have been blessed through our music. A lot of hands, a lot of mind, a lot of talent was put together to make us go. So that's kind of the short story about us. And it's funny, you have Cuba on the phone with us. He was there when we started. So and we still are very good friends to this day. And then Cuba decided to fire us and go solo. I'm playing. He left. Hey, Stevie. Mr. Radio Host, how does the group get fired, Doc? You know what I mean?
Now, come on, fellas. Now, you all going to have to tell us this story now. You all were together since 1999. And the group.
As a matter of fact.
That's awesome. And now, the group broke up in 1999, or what happened?
We stopped. Okay, so what happened?
Hey, Cuba, let me, is that you talking, Cuba? Because that noise, I'm going to have to put you.
No, that's not me.
Okay.
I'm good. Can you hear
me? Yeah, I hear you. Okay, now go ahead now. Now, what's the story in 1999? What happened?
So what happened was the conception actually was a little, maybe a couple years before that. I was in college, and my cousin ended up marrying a guy in California, and this guy just so happened to be named Lawrence Brown. And so that's where we first met. He's the slim guy in our group. And but we were singing in the car, just kind of messing around, you know. And and we said, man, if you were in Houston, well, we probably could do something because I like how we sound together. And maybe
could
a couple
you,
years
hey,
excuse later.
Excuse me. Could you give us the name of the members of the group? We never got that.
Certainly. Well, initially, the founders of the group was myself, Monte Cuba, Lawrence Brown is the guy I'm referencing now,
okay.
Cornelius Edwards, and later on it was Robert Milton. There was a couple of guys we was trying to find for that fifth slot, and it ended up the lot ended up falling on Robert Milton. So that was the kind of the five that we started swinging with, if you will, and it ended up being some great chemistry there. So that was the initial five.
Man, I'm going to tell you, listening to you guys, you when I first came on the air and I heard your music, you guys really sound very professional in your presentation. And
Thank you.
You remind, you know, you it's just very soulful. And then we're going to play some of your tracks here in just a few minutes. And I'll tell you, you're one of the groups that I'm very impressed with out of all the groups that I have on my roster, because my active roster consists of about 110 groups on my active roster. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah. and that's just mm-hmm. a lot of great a cappella artists, but you guys, your presentation comes across very smooth. You're very harmonious, and I think our listeners are really going to enjoy what they are hearing from this group, The Soul Influence. Now, I have some questions from my dear friend Linda Dilly. She wanted to participate in this radio show, and she agreed to write the questions for the artists when we do the interviews on the show. So I'll be asking you a few of those questions as we go through this interview. Let me ask you one of her questions before we play your first two tracks that we want to play. We want to hear from this group, The Soul Influence. Got some great music, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to really enjoy what you're hearing from this group tonight. Now, Marcus, would you finish telling your story? I didn't mean to cut you off.
Sir, you can ask. You probably however you want to lay out the show. We have stories for days.
Okay.
You could attest to that. So I think I addressed your initial. That's the name. Those were the names of the group members when we first launched.
Now, how did you all come up with the name The Soul Influence? I think that's an interesting name.
Cuba was a part of that process. We started. Oh man, Cuba, what was our first name?
Infinity.
Right. My dad. What's funny, Cuba? My dad sitting right here, and he called it out before I did. Infinity.
Wow.
Right. So Cuba actually named the group Infinity. That
did you all have any? Did you all have any recordings under that name?
We did not.
No.
I think we came out of that name so fast. How long were we Infinity, Cuba?
1.5 seconds.
What happened? Why'd you change?
Cuba, do you remember? I'm going to say Cuba remembers.
I think somebody else, I think it was another group out there or something that had that name. And then we I don't think we were really just feeling that name. So we had to come up with something that touched everybody as a whole.
Right.
I think that's kind of what it was in a nutshell.
Yeah, Stevie, it was one that was part of it. We came together so fast, and the chemistry happened so quickly, and we started taking off. So we kind of just, hey, we need a name, you know?
Right.
We can't just be the guys, you know what I mean? So we came up with the name, but then as we started digging into it, we I can appreciate, and I thank you for your observation and your critique of us. We did start out trying to be extremely professional. So we appreciate that, because that's what we were after. And
I mean, I look at your pictures.
From the business perspective, we really had to start looking at names that were available for websites and just something that can have a more far reaching impact than even what we initially thought.
Hey, I tell you, brother, I'm loving what I'm seeing.
You got both of us on the phone tonight.
Yeah, I'm loving what I'm seeing from this group, man. You look the part now. You looking the part. You know,
thank you.
You looking the part, and you are definitely sounding real
Cuba,
good.
And
man.
Cuba and I, we were insistent on. We were insistent. Believe me, and Cuba could probably tell you right now. One of the things that probably grates our nerves is when groups take the stage on behalf of God, and you look in any kind of way. We were insistent on looking.
That's right.
Right, presentable, professional.
That's right.
At least. To the best of our ability, what was within our financial constraints, at least, you know, doing the best with what was in our hands. So we definitely strove to do that.
Now, let me ask you one of these questions that Linda Dilly has before we go into your music. Now,
okay.
This question is, do you feel as a group that racial barriers in the music industry have improved or worsened since the civil rights movement?
Mm. Cuba, you want me to take it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Well, ask it one more time because I want to make sure I hit it correctly.
Okay. Do you feel as a group that racial barriers in the music industry have improved or worsened since the civil rights movement?
Well, since the civil rights movement, that's taking it back to mid 60s, I believe gospel music, racial relations within that scope has improved. Now, if we're talking about performances, and I have to kind of categorize that. If we're talking performances, opportunities, opportunities abroad, opportunities domestically, I believe it has improved. Now, from a record label standpoint, I may not can say that. It's two different. There's the performance side, and then there's the business side. I do believe from the business side, it did not necessarily improve. I do believe that there were still bad record deals being signed. I believe people directly from a racial component, from a racial perspective, that things did get worse. Cooper, you want to add to that?
Yeah, and I kind of concur with that because, and I believe that back then it was seemed like it was so much easier to go and perform without all the biases that people have now, and also with now it's so hard to even get a record deal in the gospel music industry now because everybody knows a small circle, and if you're not in that circle, you're not invited to that circle. It has its positives and negatives about it, but as Marcus was saying, I believe it's improved in some parts, but in the performance as far as getting venues and things of that nature, not so much.
Well, all right, let's go ahead and get into some of this music. We want to hear from the Soul Influence. Now, you all have two albums, the 2001 album Persuaded and your 2007 album, You Gotta Believe, both great albums. I really enjoy what I'm hearing from this group. Who came up with the perspective on your 2001 album Persuaded?
Our writer and producer, our chief writer and producer was Jesse Marat. And just as the album was taking shape, as the Lord was moving in our lives and was growing us, even developing us during that season of recording, of being produced, it just started taking shape. And just the album idea, our freshman album, our initial effort, we were really trying to make sure we persuaded a lot of people in a lot of different areas. One is that professionalism thing. You don't have to have a record deal to do what we were doing. Let's persuade you to do some things in that vein. Let's persuade you to go ahead and get a group, whatever the Lord is moving you to do, go ahead and do it in a professional way. We wanted to persuade you to obey the gospel of Jesus Christ. Whether it be through our music, whether it be through seeing five positive young black guys taking the stage, we did games, professional games, football, basketball, baseball. We did graduation. Just wherever we were the brand, and we were the ambassadors for Jesus Christ. So we were seeking to persuade men and women, boys and girls everywhere, to be better, to be Christians, to live better lives if you were a Christian, just to dream big. So it was. It was all encompassing when we thought of our initial freshman project.
When we listen to this music now, having the backstory on this album, you get a new perspective from it. You know what I'm saying? How about your 2007 album, You Gotta Believe? Now, I didn't know Jesse Barrow produced that first album. I didn't know that.
Yeah, he produced the second album.
Jesse got his head in everything, don't he?
Well, we share some production efforts on that one with another guy by the name of Eric Carrington. But Jesse Monroe still was the, kind of the quarterback of that. The You Gotta Believe album was just one of those things where let's come out. It's our sophomore project. And just our walk through, and we're still, we went through kind of personnel changes and that sort of thing. And I believe in just in some kind of way, we all are still connected. And no matter what any individual decided to do, it still was about belief. You have to believe. Yep. And if you want to be saved, you got to believe. And there's a lot of folk that's just not believing these days. You know, so we'll speak to that later. But that's kind of what we want to drive that nail home. You've got to believe. And we have a title project, a title song after the title of the project.
Now, is the group still together?
Yes.
Okay. So any future projects on the horizon?
I think when Cuba gets ready to produce us, I think that's when we're going to come out with it.
Okay.
No, it's a different day, though. Cuba can probably attest to you. We do hope to have one, but we have to be real calculating in this environment. Because it costs the cost outlay for something like that and the time. And I think I think you're wrapping up yours right now.
Yeah, 2 weeks. Yeah.
Right. But he could tell you that he was trying to have that out probably third quarter last year.
Right.
Yeah. The things that happened and the things people don't see just the effort that it takes trying to pull. Fly guys in, you got to rehearse, and then sometimes you can have a song, you're ready to go, but things just don't go right that night.
Right.
Or your voice is not in tune, or there's some intricate details within harmonies. And sometimes it's like a sermon. It's like, I mean, you know, I preach, he preaches, and sometimes how you practice it in your head ain't what happened on Sunday morning.
Right.
But then sometimes it goes beyond what you practice in your head, too. So, and once you could deliver a lead, Stevie, and it's just outweighing the background, man. You hear that, now you got to redo the background.
Right.
It's just, like the spirit comes in at different points, and you got to be open to that, and you got to be open to what the spirit is doing. Sometimes that background is hidden, and the lead has to come up, or we got to support it. So it's a very much a work in progress, and it's very much an inviting of the spirit into your work. So the spirit moves when he wants to move, not when we want him to move, too. You know what I mean?
Well, let's go ahead and get into some of this music. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to hear from the Soul Influence. We have Marcus Barnum and Cuba, Monte Cuba, on the broadcast with us tonight. They are members and former members of the group The Soul Influence from Houston, Texas. I just love this group. You're going to love what you're hearing from this group. Now, the first two singles that we want to start the show off with is Clap Your Hands from your 2007 album, You Gotta Believe. What's the backstory on this song, Clap Your Hands? Who wrote this song?
So Jesse Monroe wrote this song, and that was about when we started the flow of recording this project. It was the second song that we recorded. And, man, we was like, man, we wanted something upbeat, wanted something that was fun. We wanted something that could lift spirits, and the way that this song, we put it at the first track of this whole project. So that's kind of the backstory, man. We want something fun. Then we just started. No one ever, you know, we clap our hands, blah blah blah. We lift our hands. So I remember some of those songs like from Kirk Carr. I said, man, let's do something upbeat and let's encourage the people of God, and really support. In verse and in words and in lyrics, reasons to clap your hands.
Amen. Now, the second single that we have that we want to play is That's All I Think About from your 2007 album, You Gotta Believe. What's the backstory on that?
Now, that was the first song. When I say Clap Your Hands was the second, That's All was the first song. And
That's All?
Yes, sir. That's All was the first song on that. We started rehearsing. We came in and we started with that chorus, All I Think About Is You. That's what I'm about to do. I do everything I need to be pleasing to you. More and more each day, I'm determined to stay. Ain't no way, no how that I'm going to be leaving. That's all I think about. So it was just a feel-good, mid-tempo groove, good riding music, good performance song. It has a harmony break a crowd participation break towards the end in the vamp. So it has several different components in That's All that music lovers would appreciate.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, we got the soul influence from Houston, Texas, Marcus Bonham and Monte Cuba on the ride with us tonight, and I think you're really going to enjoy what you're hearing from this group, the soul influence. Brothers, thank you for riding with us on the blast tonight. Certainly appreciate it. Now, we're going to kick off this show like with these two singles, Clap Your Hands, and That's All I Think About from the soul influence. Enjoy this double play. You got Stevie B on the ones and twos.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
You're in the mix with Stevie B, the Blaster Master of Acapella Gospel Music.
Here we go, yeah. Who everybody wants to be one, but nobody wants to try. If you want to get the glory land, the saints don't gather round. I looked in the book of life and my name was found. Nobody want to live the kind of life that God wants a man to live. Nobody wants to sacrifice them, give like the Father gives. Somebody got to volunteer, somebody got to take a stand. Somebody needs to represent and find one Christian man. Come on.
Mama told me, yeah. years ago. Seek Jesus and don't let go.
That's all I think about. That's all I'm thinking about.
To my auntie Lynette Jones. She lives in Harlem, north of New York. And yesterday was her birthday. Happy birthday, Auntie Lynette Jones. Stevie B wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Yo, this is Teray Mack representing Mack Music in Jacksonville, Florida, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
My name is Dasha Dalton, and I sing with Truly Blessed. You're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the Soul Influence riding with us on the blast tonight, Marcus Barnum and Monte Cuba. Gentlemen, thank you for riding with us on the blast tonight.
Thank you for having us. Thank you for having
thank you,
us.
Thank you, thank you, thank
you. We flying 30,000 feet now. Now. I have another question I want to ask you guys before I play your next two singles. Hearing your name, The Soul Influence, this is Linda Dilley. Hearing your name, The Soul Influence, has inspired me to ask what influence your group has had in the music industry.
Well, I think initially it was something powerful. We were on our way to something powerful. When we first started out, we ended up really making an impact with the level of sales that we were getting all across the country, the invites that we were getting, and remember, I got to put it in context. This was before the social media outlets that we have today. Man, we had social media back then with the Spotify's and the stream plays and that sort of thing. It would have been something special to see. But initially what we had was great sales, and then we were able to sign early on. We ended up securing the services of management and an executive producer, and we were on our way actually to getting nominated for a Grammy.
Wow.
And we would have been. We did the numbers to be nominated for a Grammy in our division. And
wow.
But what happened, our early numbers were not recorded correctly.
You know,
showing up to the church and stuff, and we selling out in the back of the church. You know, we stopping at gas stations and in the airports, and y'all, you know, because we that whole professional look, we that's how we walked, that's how we drove into a place, that's how we traveled, and mm-hmm. so we didn't want to make any mistake about it. We looked like a group. We were ambassadors for Christ. We're not hiding this. And so we were able to be blessed. We just, you know, we didn't log those numbers. We were selling at the airport, running around. You know, we were just, remember at the beginning of the conversation, I told you we took off so fast.
Right.
And the Lord blessed it. And we just did not have our ducks in a row from a business perspective. That's that whole, when we get into it later, the racial divides and stuff, when we get into that, we really could have been. So I think we did have an influence. I do think, to answer your question, we were able to show others that it could be done, doing it
right
with the model and then the way that we were doing it. And we were just
right.
really, man, we just wanted to try to encourage some young people out there, boys, man, because singing can be frowned upon. A lot of boys, a lot of young men went into rap and probably
mm-hmm.
had great vocal ability, but it wasn't cool to sing. So we like to think we made it cool to be a singer, cool to sing, bring it up
right.
close and personal. We don't have to apologize for anything. The Lord is blessing us right in the face.
No, you ain't got to apologize
for the Lord. So,
no, you ain't got to apologize for nothing.
But that's how some people, you know, they even in the church, they'll cower down to other societal pressures.
Mm-hmm.
And so that people apologizing that the Lord is working in their lives, they apologizing for having to go to church, apologizing
wow.
for being a Christian. You know what I'm talking about, man. We don't play that.
Oh yeah. I tell you,
your victory and walk with your head held high.
That's one thing I like about doing this radio show. We try to keep it real as far as what we're doing here.
Yes, sir. Yes,
and
sir.
And if anybody who knows me can see my platform on social media, they see what I'm doing. They can see that I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm not ashamed.
Yes, sir.
And that's why I really enjoy this work that I'm doing here. Not just on this show here on Friday night, but on Tuesdays and Thursday night. Because we're preaching the gospel on Tuesday and Thursday night. Go ahead.
Hey, Cuba, would you like to add anything to that? What you know, do you think we were impactful, you know?
Yeah, we were. And believe it or not, of course, you know, during that time, you know, we were young, but we were genuine. But we still had a lot of haters out there that didn't want to see us succeed. When people heard that, you know, we sung with on Bobby Gospel, BET Bobby Gospel Show, we sung with Fred Hammond, Justin McKirkland, Destiny's Child, all of these people that we sung on stages with, people, they frowned on that. Is that y'all think y'all arrived? Y'all think, no, we're not doing it, we were just blessed to have the opportunity to sing in stages with them. So we were always kept.
Cuba brings up a good point. I forgot about that, Cuba. He brings up a good point. He's right. We shared the stages with folk other than gospel. Like we did this big old thing with Monica, the R&B sensation, Brandy. We shared the stage with other gospel artists, like big time folks. And so, man, we can't attribute that to nobody but God. But I do think we were able to make an impact. Like we were a relative unknown, and we still are relative unknown by industry standards. But man, we hit the scene hard, and there were people that were doing it better than us, longer than us, wasn't getting the opportunities that we were afforded, and I believe it was because of how we started. We professionalism, the sound, being genuine on stage. Man, we would mess up and laugh about it.
People wouldn't know it. People wouldn't know it.
Right.
Oh, okay.
Right.
That does make a difference, you know, as far as your professionalism is concerned, you know.
Yeah.
Well, we got two more singles, man, that we want to play. Now, this is one of my favorite songs here. Ain't No Use from your 2007 album, You Gotta Believe. And that'll be followed by Keep My Light in my Window. I like that song as well. Give us the backstory on Ain't No Use.
Ain't No Use, man. That was just a throwback song. It was one of the first times I heard it. It's more of a re-engineered song, a remix, a remake, a song that we kind of put our flavor on. It's an old throwback from the Mighty Clouds of Joy. That was one of my dad's favorite groups, one of my favorite groups, Joe Lagun, and so when you go back to those kinds of songs. I think on their song, the great Paul Beasley and his falsetto led that thing along with Joe. So it's an old throwback that we kind of re-engineered and we rearranged to fit us. And we thought it would be a blessing to the people, just a throw. Because, you know, I think sometimes you can be too contemporary. I think taking it back to church, giving an old throwback sound with a contemporary feel, with a contemporized group, singing an old song actually has a different kind of flavor. So, you know, I think that was a good flavor for us. And you can tell, too.
When the song first starts off, you can tell, well, this sounds like a 1960s right here.
Yes, sir.
What about the song Keep My Light in the Window? That's another nice song as well.
It's one of those songs where it's a strong contemporary song, but it has a good message. And we like to use the term churchy. It's not too churchy, but it can relate to the church. And it's not too churchy enough where it can't relate to mankind who may be unchurched. So that was the idea of arranging that one and putting that one together. And it just speaks to, and it has an inspirational tone, a motivational message, and something that I think everybody could feel no matter where you are. And if we could draw you to Christ with the others or just by perking your ear up with that one, to God be glory.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, we got the Soul Influence on the broadcast with us tonight, Marcus Bonham and Monte Cuba riding with us on the blast tonight. Let's enjoy this double play. I got Ain't No Use and Keep My Light in the Window. You guys, Stevie B on the ones and twos.
Said it ain't no use.
My window.
She's a school teacher there in Charlotte, North Carolina. Denise Fentz, Stevie B, wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hello, family. This is Steve Adams, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
This your girl, Toni Washington, from Journey Acapella. And you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone. And you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Oh, yeah.
Blaster Master of Acapella Gospel Music.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got the Soul Influence riding with us on the blast tonight, Marcus Barnum and Monte Cuba from Houston, Texas. How you doing, gentlemen? Oh, man. I didn't have your mics on. Sorry about that. How you doing, gentlemen? How you enjoying the ride?
Oh, doing well. Doing well.
Doing well.
Thank you for having us. Thank you for having us. Having a good time tonight.
Yes, sir. Certainly appreciate you riding with us on the blast. I am loving the Soul Influence, and I think our listeners are really enjoying what they're hearing on this broadcast as well. Certainly appreciate it, man. Now, before we close out this segment, I have one more question that I want to ask you. And that is, will you be performing during the summer with the coronavirus pandemic still going on?
That's going to be a no.
Now, let me ask you, before we let you guys go, we never did get the complete story of that 1999 breakup.
No, we didn't. That's when we started. That's when the group started.
Oh, that's when you started. So when was the breakup?
No, we haven't broke up. We just went through just through the years, personnel changes.
Okay.
Still going strong. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I thought somebody got fired. I thought somebody said that.
Cuba, you hear him trying to be messed up in there?
Hey, I'm scratching. I'm scratching at it.
No, what happened? I can tell you what happened directly. There was just the first personnel change was Cornelius Edwards, and then we signed on Jeremy Roberts. Jeremy actually is from Houston, and went to church with us, baptized in the church here. My dad is his father in the gospel, so he became a member of the group, and then went through some other personnel changes. Just life starts happening, and I tell you directly, Cuba ended up being employed. What was that? Cuba, Lake Jackson, somewhere out there.
Yeah, Lake Jackson.
Like
yeah.
His
yeah.
job and other work pressures took him away, and just made rehearsing and just keeping up so very very hard. And so it actually launched his solo career, but it was something that was more in tune with his schedule. It was just a lot of stuff that took place, but everybody that was in this group actually still their imprint is still in this group as we go on right now. We still laugh about dudes and have fun and reminded in practice about everybody that has walked through the group. So they still have a big imprint on what we do, what we've done, and they're very much a part of this group as anybody else.
Now, before I let you go, before we close this segment out, is there anybody you all want to give a shout out to? I'm getting some background noise.
I would start. Yeah, I would give a shout out to the current group as it's structured. Donis Lemon was the latest addition. His family is part of the Church of Christ Heritage Group, the Lemon Five. So he comes from that.
Oh, okay.
Lawrence Brown. Lawrence Brown, Robert Melton, they're still two of the original members that are still a part of it. And then, of course, Arzell Drain. But through the years, we've had Justin Woodard. He was an alternate in the group at one point, and then he became a member of the group. And then he had some health issues that kind of took him away, but God is blessing him. So, just straight up to those guys and to our families that sacrificed through the years. To all the churches, to the ministers, to all of the youth ministers and singles ministries, the marriage ministries, just the things that we've done through the years. Not even just on the church sector, but the political sectors, the number of people we were involved with in their marriage ceremonies. Those are just as important as any gospel concert that we've done. So birthday serenades, all of those were instrumental in bringing joy to somebody's life and us having an imprint on somebody's heart. So we're just grateful to everyone that has touched us, believe it or not, in any kind of way. They could have picked anybody, and we were chosen.
Right.
That they felt about us in that way. We're grateful. I'll give Cuba a chance, if he wants to. And Cuba, what you think?
Okay, I mean, I concur with your, what Marcus was saying, because everybody who's in our beginning have touched our lives in so many ways to launch us to where we are right now in our personal lives now. At some at some point, they touched our lives. Even, you know, give a shout out to East Sage or Jesse, who for you know, even trusting us to write for certain songs that we didn't think we could possibly do.
Right.
And he pulled it out.
Yeah,
of,
you know what? I'm sorry. I got to apologize. That's number one. He, every project that you planned for us, he wrote. And we gave life to what he wrote. So I apologize for that, man. Yeah, he.
Well, big
he,
up
yeah,
to
number two, but he the one that, he's the one that made us think we could record something. Remember?
Right.
Well, big up.
Right, we could do it. Yeah.
Yeah. Now I have two more. Oh, Monty, would you finish your shout out?
No, I was good. Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. Now I have two more tracks I want to close this segment out with. We have "Thank You" from your 2001 album "Persuaded."
Lord have mercy.
And "Weakness." Now "Thank You" is no "Weakness" is number four on my top 20 countdown show for the month of May. I just love that song, "Weakness." But "Thank You," let's give the backstory for "Thank You."
Woo, Cuba, you had to help me with that one.
Yeah, my "Thank You" was one of, we weren't expecting "Thank You," first of all, and we were kind of asking East Sage at that time that we need to thank the Lord for some of this. We on this journey, but we didn't have one song to thank the Lord for all everything he's given us, you know. And
right.
So, and during that time, you know, he came up with the melody and the verses. Then it was still missing something. And then that's when, you know, I think Cornelius was kind of just fiddling around with you know, just rap, you know, whatever, because that's what he liked to do is rap.
Mm-hmm.
And he came up with that rap. He came. That's all corn. That rap part at the end of that song, and that's what made the song what it is. When we was trying to figure out how in the world we gonna thank the Lord for all this stuff that we've done, and because it wasn't us,
right?
But he brought people in our midst to for this journey that we did have.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, go ahead. "Weakness." Give us the backstory for "Weakness."
Well, I'm sorry. "Weakness" was, it's weird, because it starts off with this Halloweenish kind of thing, these little screams. And
man,
and
I love that song.
We were just kind of playing around, and then the guys were playing around, and then we dropped the beat on that. It's a time to let somebody know, and it just... East Age was just a master at constructing stuff and just grabbing stuff out of the air, really, and making it purposeful. And we just know he's led in his lyrics just by the Holy Ghost. And this one that we want, that's one of my favorite tunes as well. It's one of those songs that if you're down and out, you encourage yourself. You're in the army of the Lord. In your weakness, that's when Jesus will make you strong. Is very scripturally based in the lyric content. So, you know, it's just one of those uplifting things that we all, and it's a reminder that we can get weak sometimes. We all get weak. We all tend to fall short. We all get weary in well-doing, but that's when Jesus can bring the power. That's really where he wants us. When we depleted all of our strength, that's really when he does his best work. And so in our weakness, Jesus brings the power, and that's no mistaking that lyric that was written.
Yes, sir. That's a great song. Hey, that's one of my go-tos when I'm in a crunch on my playlist on Friday night.
Awesome. We got to see what we can do to make that number one on this list, though.
I know that's right. Hey, guys. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, we had the Soul Influence riding with us on the blast tonight from Houston, Texas, Marcus Barnum and Monte Cuba. Hey, guys, we certainly appreciate you riding with us. I really enjoyed this interview with you guys. A lot of good history there and a lot of good information. It's always good to know the artists that we're playing on this radio show. Certainly appreciate it.
Yes, sir. We thank you so much for having us.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have this double play from the Soul Influence. Thank you. And Weakness. You got Stevie B on the ones and twos.
Hey, church people. Do you thank the Lord today? And you thank him for all the many blessings that he has bestowed upon you. You need to. I thank him each and every day of my life.
First thing on my agenda is to say, Lord, I thank you. These praises I surrender to you, Lord.
Thank you.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. I wanna
thank you
to wake us up early this morning.
Thank you.
My arms are sent up early to you, Lord.
Thank you.
Now you have my spirit flowing so I can soar.
Thank you.
My tears only lasted a moment.
Thank you.
'Cause joy comes in the morning.
Last time I
Thank you, God. Oh, yeah, it was just yesterday. I reflected on what you done for me and that price of death you paid. If I had my way, I'd have the whole world give me applause. Immune together, speaking other tongues. Like God and Yahs, we adore the Lord. That's why we're singing this song. If I control it that way, I play it all day long. Bless me with versatility to go. Scoot 'em, why don't you? I don't have to say words. You let me scat and praise you, and I can get in the zone. When I'm scared without control, Lord, I hope the flow is seasoning up the quiet season. Would I rhyme without a reason? Praise your name in all seasons. I'm a hard fighting soldier, never be dropping treason. They're praising you is right, the soul that wants don't want to be wrong.
Come in, and encourage your soul in your wings.
I want to give a shout out to Savoy, last man standing, Abner from Greensboro, North Carolina. Savoy, Stevie B wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, this is Melissa Lancaster with the singing group Durant, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
This is Orlando Tisdale, a.k.a. Mookie, and you are listening to me on Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Dum, 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 dum.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Coming up next, we got my song of the week. This week, we are featuring the Mario Brothers, featuring Mario McKinnon from Charlotte, North Carolina. I did an exclusive interview with Mario McKinnon. That's episode 175. That was the last show that I did before I was ill back in May. That's episode 175. And the single that we are playing is, actually, we got two singles. Now, listen to this, ladies and gentlemen. I've got the Mario Brothers, their single, Pick Me Up. And we also have a remix from that song, Pick Me Up, that was done. And Pick Me Up is from the 2015 album, The Mario Brothers. Now, on this remix, there is a variety of artists on this remix. Steve Adams, Kelly Neal from the group Revelations, Genesis Archer from Total Praise, Frank Johnson. There's just a lot of artists on this remix. So you're going to really enjoy my song of the week. Enjoy my song of the week by the Mario Brothers. You guys, Stevie B on the ones and twos and the remix.
Lord, you picked me up when I was down. Lord, you planted my feet on solid ground. Lord, I once was blind, but now I see. Oh, Lord, dear Lord, look down on me.
Lord, you picked me up when I was down.
Lord, you planted
my feet on solid ground.
The Bible says in 1 Peter 2 and verse 9, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye may show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light.
Loving Savior, oh mighty God, look down on me, Lord, when times get hard.
Show me the way, show me your power. You seem to pick me up in my darkest hour.
This is my prayer, this is my plea. When I'm struggling, you comfort me.
I know you will deliver right on time, cause you'll pick me up, Lord, when I was down. Yeah,
pick me up,
pick me up,
when I was down.
I was down, Lord, you planted my feet
on solid ground.
On solid ground.
Once was blind,
Lord, I once was blind,
but now
thank
I
God
see.
And I can see.
Lord, dear Lord,
yeah. Shown to us, even when we don't deserve them, Lord, you never give up.
Though we get hard sometimes, down in despair, when I read your word, I know you're always there.
Send me a blessing, send me a sign. When the storms are raging, Lord, I know I'm on your mind.
I know you will deliver right on time, cause you pick me up and everything's alright.
Yeah. When I was down,
yes, you did.
Planted my feet
on solid ground. I'm gonna want to give.
in my feet, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. I was in darkness, but you showed me the light. Oh, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Lord, you picked me
like nobody else could. Uh-huh. When God's on my side, everything is all good. Life's kind of hard from the things that I've seen.
Yeah.
But Lord, have mercy, glad we're on the same team.
Lord,
you picked me up, God, when no one was around. Through it all, Lord, you never let me down.
Just
want to thank you
and
have to praise you.
Uh-huh.
So much to say to you, my life, I hate you.
Come on,
no one can match it. Your love is a classic. I need your passion. What I want, I just ask it. You bless my heart. I don't know where to start. Only God in heaven, he can bring us. Yeah, life is full of some heartache and pain. And he came in my life, things ain't never been the same. So I look in the sky, I look and see my King. I know he's in heaven, he's looking down on me.
Pick me up
when I was down.
I was down, but you planted my feet
on solid ground.
Lord, I once was blind, but thank God that I can't see. Yeah, yeah.
Everywhere that I go, cause his peace is everlasting.
How can I be happy when my life seems upside down? Well, let me tell you about a man named Jesus. He's the true joy that I found.
Yes, that's the Mario Brothers. Pick Me Up. I just love that song. And the remix. I hope you've enjoyed my song of the week.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Coming up next, we got a new single from Nia Purpose from Fort Mill, South Carolina. That song is entitled Free. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy my single play. You got Stevie B on ones and twos.
Look into the sunset sky. I could ask a million whys. Searching for a ray of hope for every shadow in my soul. Locked up in the hurt and fear, wondering how the dark got here. Numbing doesn't heal at all. Father, could you make me whole? I just wanna be free. I just want to be free. To sit back and breathe. I just want to be free. Reveling in mercy deep.
you're changing me. Dreaming like a child again, going back where we began. Innocent as love takes hold, living the impossible. I just wanna be free.
Some feedback going on here. Yeah. I want to give a shout out to Grizel House. She works with Apple Support and she lives in Northern Illinois. Grizel House, I told you I wasn't going to forget about you. Stevie B wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hello, I'm Thurman Metters with the Ministry Church of Christ Adult Chorus, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, y'all, this is Stephanie Booker Wilson of Stephanie Sings Vocal Studio, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B. Boom, boom, baby.
I need you to reach out and take my hand.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Hey.
Dropping the beat.
Stevie B, the Blaster Master.
Acapella Gospel Music.
All right, it's time to make a telephone call. We kicked off our new promotion back in May. I'm going to give away a free CD and a gift from one of my sponsors, Yvonne Blazing Cracker Gooch from Nashville, Tennessee. So let's make the call.
Hello, this is Mia.
You're on the air with Stevie B. What's your name and what city and state do you live in?
Hi, this is Mia Wiley from Fort Mill, South Carolina.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I just played the new single. Did you hear your new song?
I didn't. I was actually outside trying to enjoy some of the nice warm weather.
I'm so
glad to hear that you played it.
Yeah, well, you know, you can always go to Spotify, iHeartRadio, Apple iTunes, and listen to this show after I go off the air.
Yes,
you didn't know
yes,
that, right?
I do. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I did. I saw it. I was on your page on Spotify just the other day.
Oh, okay, cool. Now, the reason that I'm calling you is because I have a gift for you. I want to give you a free CD of some great acapella gospel music, and I have a gift from one of my sponsors, Yvonne Blazing Cracker Gooch from Nashville, Tennessee. That's what we for you. And the reason that I'm giving it to you is because we just want to thank our listeners for their love and support for this radio show.
Well, thank you. I really appreciate that, and appreciate you for playing my music too. So thank you.
Hey, as I always tell you, I love your music. You have some real nice music. I just really enjoy it. So we just want to give you these gifts from the Blast, and we just want to show our appreciation. So stay
thank
with
you.
Me.
Thank you. I appreciate it so much.
Yeah, thanks. So just stay with me in just a few minutes, and we can get your address, and we can send those out to you, okay?
Okay, sounds good.
That's Neil Purpose, ladies and gentlemen. Neil Wiley from Fort Mill, South Carolina. She's receiving some prizes from us on the broadcast this evening. Certainly appreciate you, Neil.
Thank you. I appreciate you, too.
All right.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
It's time for my funny bones. You know I love those comedians because laughter is good for the soul.
How many of y'all mamas? How many mamas in the place? Mama stuck with me though, because you know I ain't always do, you know, Christian comedy. You know, I start off on the other side. I believe I see a few witnesses. You know, I started out on the other side, but Mama stuck with me. You know, she stuck with me. She supported me until I came and brought it on in. But, you know, every time, you know, they had a revival, she was trying to invite me on in, trying to get me real saved. You know. Yeah. Because, you know, all that kind of saved. You know, I was saved, but there's some stuff I was still trying to hold on to. You know that kind of saved. You be saved, but not quite delivered. There it is. That's where I was, you know. So every time they had revival, Mama invite me out. Baby, what you doing this week? I said, I'm working every night. She said, you must have heard about the revival. I said, yes, ma'am, they had it on the radio. She said, oh, okay. You in town? I said, yes, I'm in town. Okay, then. She said, well, what time you get finished? I said, I get finished around 10. She got me. She said, well, you know, we'll still be in service. Won't you just stick your head in the door? I said, okay, Mama. You know, you got to please Mama. So I tried to get to the church. You know, he's about 12. But, you know, I'm trying to get there for the catfish dinner. Because the mother's boy did not play. You can get 3 pieces of catfish, coleslaw, and spaghetti for $3. And the sweet tea was free. So, you know, I'm trying to get the cat is down. I get to the church midnight, right? I see the lights still on. I said, well, maybe they're getting ready to have a benediction. Honey, I walk in that church, people running around in circles, jumping over pews. The preacher hadn't even got up yet. I said, these folks ain't ready to go nowhere. I said, I'm going to wait them out. So I go, I sit on the back pew. I'm going to wait them out. Right here until they finish. The preacher got up. Y'all sat down. Stop the music. Y'all sat down. Come here, baby. Now, I'm on the back row, but I do like everybody else. Ooh. said you to just come in. Come here, daughter. Come in. I'm walking down there. I'm like, Lord, come on. I said, Lord, I'm tired. I'm tired. Please don't let this man knock me down. I get down there, and true enough, he had a word from God. So he told me what God had to say. But evidently, God didn't tell him what I said. Because before I knew, whew, I was on the floor. And y'all, I promise, a lady out of nowhere just came and threw some cover over me. Well, all right, then, all right. And then another lady came, and for no reason at all, she just started fanning me. So I called, appreciate it. Because I went on ahead and took me a nap. Now, that's what I call resting in the Lord. Honey, when I woke up, church was over. But nobody there but me and them two ladies. And they just walking by me, God is really doing the work on her. I turned over, I said, yes, he is. Y'all ever been shouting? I mean, you showing up feeling the spirit. You ever been shouting? You was getting ready to run down the aisle, and you saw somebody big coming down the aisle. You're like, oh, no, no. Think I'll take this route right now. This look a little safer. Now, you know, the ushers will look out for you, don't they? They may sit on nothing happen to you. I don't shout unless I got an usher with me. I feel the spirit. I be like, oh, hold on. Can I get an usher over here, please? Yeah, I feel the spirit. Thank you, baby. Watch my purse coming to you. Ushers gonna look out for her. They will look out. Say, I'll crump. You know, I'll crump for Christ. So what I did, I got me a job at the church because I figured that would give me an incentive. What is it, baby? Yeah, that's it. A reason to be there on a regular basis. So I started playing the drums in the church, you know what I'm saying? Because that came easy to me. I was already a little tomboy, so you know I played the drums. And it was easy because I played doing testimony service. Y'all know all them songs go to the same beat anyway. Only problem I had when the older women like to make up their own songs. And then get mad at me because I can't keep up with them. I'm like, hey, now, you the one over there freestyling. You the only one in here know the words. So hold on, Jesus. I'll be there in a minute. Hold on, Jesus. I'll be there in a minute. And like, she is making this up. And my grandmama, she just remixed Jesus on the main line. I know y'all know the traditional version. Go Jesus on the main line. Oh, Jesus on the main line. Jesus on the main line. Oh, call him up and tell him. You go, Grandma. Oh, 569 him. You know, when they testified, they explained the song that they made up. You say, you know, Jesus might call you, but you might not be there. But don't worry, all you got to do is start 69 him back to see where he was. Grandma, I think he lost it. I don't know. Now, y'all know how preachers, they be preaching, and then after they preach, they fall into like a prophetic anointing, and they can just start prophesying to anybody. This preacher did that. He finished preaching. He's calling people out. Like, come here. You. So it ended up being like 20 people in the line. And I was first. You know, I was sitting closer to the front. So I ended up first in the line. He was standing there. He was prophesying to me. He was like, look at me, baby. He kept saying, look at me, baby. Look at me. But it was hard. I don't know what was going on with him. I don't know if he just ate an onion garlic sandwich. It was, you know, it's hard to stare something like that in the face, you know. And I was trying, I was like, okay. But I wanted to be submissive, so I was looking at him. Let me move my half y'all see. And you know, you trying to look at that, you know, face it on, you know, my eyes start tearing up. So, you know, once you blink, that's it. You know, tears are rolling down my face. But the altar workers didn't have a clue. They said, ooh, she is really receiving. She is really receiving. I'm like, yeah, but y'all don't know what. And I'm not a selfish person. I mean, I stood there and I took it like a woman of God. I stood strong. But I didn't want these people behind me to go through what I was going through. So I began to seek wisdom. I said, now how can I let this man know what's going on without causing a scene, without embarrassing anybody? I said, I got to let him know. These old Mike can't take it like I can take it. And it came to me. I ain't gonna say where it came from, but it came to me. We all talking about God told me. It came to me. I said, I'm gonna tell him in another language. So when he finished prophesying to me, something said, now, baby, now. So I told him, I said, tick tack, tick tack, tick tack. Tick tack, tick tack, tick tack. Peppermint. Do it right now. Alcohol. Try it. Oh, do it right now. Please do it right now. Y'all, that rough.
Yeah, you been listening to my funny bones. She knows she ain't crazy. Because laughter is good for the soul.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
This your boy Lil Lou from Athens, Alabama, and Diesel Records. Giving a shout out to my man Stevie B with the Acapella Gospel Music Blast. Every Friday night we get down just like this. Diesel Records, baby.
Today is Friday night. To keep the mood just right, Stevie B's on the radio.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're enjoying the flight tonight. We're flying 30,000 feet. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm playing some of the world's greatest acapella gospel music artists on this radio show, The Sweet Sounds of Voices. And while we're up here, I might as well go ahead and drop a bomb. I said, boom, boom. I got a double play coming your way. My group Straight Company from Louisville, Kentucky. This is one of my power groups. Their single, Didn't It Rain, from their 1997 album, Plugged In. Now, I did a marathon show with this group. That's episode number 76. That was a great show. On that show, had two of the original members, The group was established in 1975. So when I say the original members, they had to take it way back. So Jesse Mariah Isays was on that show. And also Mark Clemons, the legendary Mark Clemons, was on that show. We just had a great time on that show. And George Gunsmithy, George Smith Jr., Gunsmithy was on the broadcast with us as well. And a recorded version of that show is episode number 18. That's a great show. If you love Straight Company, you're going to love that marathon show that I did with them. And that'll be followed by my man, Monte Cuba. He was on the broadcast earlier with us tonight when he was with the group, The Soul Influence. And that is a great group. I really enjoyed chatting it up with those brothers on the broadcast tonight and listening to their music. They have some great music. So Monte has a new single out entitled Through the Storm. And this is from his 2020 album, Learning, that it hadn't been released yet. Monte said about 2 weeks. Hopefully we should be able to debut that album here soon. If not this month, it won't be in June, but hopefully in July we try to get that scheduled. And also I did an exclusive interview with Monte, episode 100, on my recorded version, episode 27. Enjoy my double play, my power group, Straight Company, and Monte Cuba. Enjoy this double play. You got Stevie B on the ones and twos.
Yeah. through the storms. There will be sorrow, there will be pain, count it all joy, through the rain. You don't have to worry, you don't have to cry, Jesus will help you.
Certainly appreciate her. Linda Dilly, she lives in, well, she used to live in Sand Springs. She's now in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Linda Dilly, Stevie B, wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, what up, guys? This is Melody Bailey, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Welcome, this is Garrick Edison of the acapella group One Hope in Christ, straight out of Louisville, Kentucky, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast Radio Show, and he's dropping bombs. Oh, boom, boom.
Hi, this is Yvonne Gooch, owner of Blazing Crackers, and I am a proud sponsor of Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Blazing Crackers, they on fire.
You need a treat, you're hungry, you need something. So you need a treat, you're hungry, shout enough hungry, need something.
Blazing Crackers,
B-L-A-Z-I-N Crackers, yeah. B-L-A-Z-I-N Crackers, yeah. B-L-A-Z-I-N Crackers, yeah.
This is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Hey. Coming up next is my monthly triple spin for the month of June. And as I stated earlier in the program, I'll still be featuring Testament Acapella Ensemble. Now, I was featuring them back in May, but I only got to do one show in May due to my illness. So I'm going to go ahead and continue on with this group for the month of June as well, so they'll get their just due on my monthly triple spin. So this group is Testament Acapella Ensemble, and the group members are Teray Mack from Jacksonville, Florida, Dajanae Barnett from Charlotte, North Carolina, Amber Baldwin from Greensboro, North Carolina, Crystal Stevenson from Greensboro, North Carolina as well. Now, I did an exclusive interview with this group. That's episode 119. Now, this is the group that recorded that single over the telephone. I always like to talk about that because I just never heard anybody doing anything like that before. And the actual single sounds real good. Now, they have a new EP that they just released, the 2020 EP entitled The Introduction, and we're going to play the three singles from that EP. The singles are I'm Here, Potter's House, and Where I Want to Be. Ladies and gentlemen, believe me when I tell you, you're going to love my monthly triple spin for the month of June. You guys, Stevie B on the ones and twos.
Whatever you want me to do, wherever you want me to go, whatever you want me to say, I love you. I am here.
Take my hand, precious Lord, and here I stand.
In case you have fallen by the wayside of life, dreams and visions shattered, you're all broken inside. You don't have to stay in the shape that you're in. The potter wants to put you back together again. Oh, the potter wants to put you back together again. In case you have fallen by the wayside of life, dreams and visions shattered, you're all broken inside. You don't have to stay in the shape that you're in. The potter wants to put
situation has been turned upside down, and all that you've accomplished is now on the ground.
I know that
you don't have to stay in the shade that you're in. The potter wants to put you back together again. Oh, the potter wants to put you back together again. You who are broken, stop by the potter's house.
You
who need
I'm
I'll be playing in just a few minutes from Dorian Paul. Dorian Paul, Stevie B, wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey family, what's good? This is Esage with Straight Company. And you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Blast, the Master Blaster. Go ahead on.
This is Troy Marables of Made New Acapella in Louisville, Kentucky, and you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Hey.
Stevie B, the Blaster Master of Acapella Gospel Music.
Coming up next, we got my song of the week. This week, we have been featuring the Mario Brothers, featuring Mario McKinnon from Charlotte, North Carolina. And I did an exclusive interview with Mario on the broadcast. That was episode 175. And the single we're taking from the Mario Brothers from their 2015 album, the Mario Brothers, is Pick Me Up. I just love that song and the remix. And on that remix, there's a variety of artists on that remix. Steve Adams, Kelly Neal from Revelation, Genesis Archer from Total Praise. And she also has her own solo project called Soldier. I just love that album she has. And Frank Johnson. And it's just a lot of artists that was on this remix. I think you're going to enjoy this song of the week. Enjoy my song of the week.
Lord, you picked me up when I was down. Lord, you planted my feet on solid ground. Lord, I once was blind, but now I see. Oh, Lord, dear Lord, look down on me.
Lord, you picked me up when I was down. Lord, you planted my feet on solid ground.
Bible says in 1 Peter 2 and verse 9, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye may show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light.
Loving Savior, oh mighty God, look down on me, Lord, when times get hard.
Show me the way, show me your power. You seem to pick me up in my darkest hour.
This is my prayer, this is my plea. When I'm struggling, you comfort me.
I know you will deliver right on time, cause you'll pick me up, Lord, when I was down.
Yeah,
pick me up
when give up. Though it gets hard sometimes, down in despair, when I read your word, I know you're always there.
Send me a blessing, send me a sign. When the storms are raging, Lord, I know I'm on your mind.
I know you will deliver right on time, cause you pick me up and everything.
Like nobody else could. Uh-huh. When God's on my side, everything is all good. Life's kind of hard from the things that I've seen.
Yeah.
But Lord, have mercy, glad we're on the same team. You picked me up, God, when no one was around. Through it all, Lord, you never let me down. Just want to thank you and have to praise you. So much to say to you, my life, I hate you.
Come on,
one can match it. Your love is a classic. I need your passion. What I want, I just ask it. You bless my heart. I don't know where to start. Only God in heaven, he can bring us this far. Yeah, life is full of heartache and pain. And he came in my life, things ain't never been the same. So I look in the sky, I look and see my king. I know he's in heaven, he looking down on me.
Pick me up when I was down.
I was down,
but you planted my feet
on solid ground.
Everywhere that I go, cause his peace is everlasting.
How can I be happy when my life seems upside down? Well, let me tell you about a man named Jesus. He's the true joy that I found. There are times I get weary, but it's the Lord who sends me. So I just put my trust and faith in him. And every time he left for me, every time you were there for me, life, I see how you bless me, though night with
till my Savior came and He reached way within.
There's a friend that I know that'll never let me go, and the love that He's shown is the best that I know. When times get rough, He lifts me up. The Lord will pick me up. The Lord will pick me up.
You pick me up.
Thanks, Steve.
Yes, that was the Mario Brothers. Pick Me Up. I just love that song. And I love that remix. I hope you've enjoyed my song of the week.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
I want to give a shout out to Angelina. Angelina Banks Fritz from Brookhaven, Mississippi. Angelina Banks Fritz, Stevie B, wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
We're United from Houston, Texas.
And you're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
What's up, everybody? This is Bruce.
This is DeMario.
This is Cranston.
This is Tori.
And this is Jordan.
We are Rain.
And you're listening to
Stevie B.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
Rochester, New York, Atlanta, Dallas, Houston, Memphis, Nashville, LA, New York City, Indianapolis, Indiana, Jacksonville, Florida, Chi-Town, Detroit City, Cleveland, Ohio, Fort Lauderdale, Oklahoma City.
When the storms of life start to come my way,
come on.
For your strength and protection is what I pray.
Come on.
Congregation in need of lending for a building or expansion project? As your partner and advocate, Diversified Financial Network will take the time to understand your unique situation and develop a financing solution that meets your specific needs. It's an exciting time for your congregation, and what you need is a company with expertise in church financing early in the process. Call us today at 1-866-513-6665 or visit us at www.diversifiedfinancegroup.com.
Stevie B's Media Production presents. We're airing live shows here on Blog Talk Radio the first Monday of the month. The next scheduled live show, the Gospel Light Radio Show, will be a special edition on July the 6th. That show will air from 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. And I'll just have one co-host giving a lesson on that broadcast. Then on Tuesday evening each week from 6 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, I'll be hosting a live show, What a Word from the Lord radio show. And each week we'll have a guest speaker from the Brotherhood of the Churches of Christ. We'll be presenting a lesson from the Word of God. Also, I have a Community Corner segment. That segment is for small business owners and entrepreneurs who have products and services that they're offering to our communities. And then my co-host, Lou Gilberts from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and Edward Bishop from Niagara Falls, New York, will be presenting lessons on this broadcast as well. Lou Gibbons will be giving a lesson on June the 9th. And then on Thursday, each week from 6 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, I'll be hosting a live show, the Gospel Light Radio Show. I have 8 co-hosts on that show who will be presenting lessons from the Word of God. And each week, 2 of my co-hosts will be on the air with me. I'm also taking questions from my social media platform on Facebook called Shout It Out. And I'll be presenting one of those questions to my co-hosts on that broadcast. And then on Friday, each week from 6 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, I'll be hosting a live show, Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast Radio Show. Now, this is a three-hour show, ladies and gentlemen. Once we go off the air at 8 o'clock, I'll still be recording this show. So when you pull up those on-demand episodes, you will get a three-hour show. That's right, a three-hour show. And we also have the Story Glory segment that we're doing on the show. That's where we're interviewing the artists that we're playing on the show. And tonight we had the Soul Influence was on the show, Marcus Barnum and Monte Cuba. That was a great interview. Really enjoyed talking to those brothers on the broadcast tonight. Now, stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. We have some upcoming events happening on June the 12th. We have Dwayne Pugh and Brad MacArthur from Dallas, Texas. They'll be debuting their new album on that broadcast. That's on June the 12th. And then on June the 26th, we have Anissa Ribble. She has a new album that will be debuting on that broadcast. That's on June the 26th. Also, for the Top 20 Countdown show, my next Top 20 Countdown show will be on June the 19th. I'll be counting down my Top 20 acapella gospel songs for the month of June. I don't have a marathon show scheduled as of yet, but I'll keep you posted on that. Now, my on-demand episodes, if you can't catch any of these live shows, just go to my affiliate internet station, wherever you're getting your favorite podcast from. Just type in your search bar, Stevie B's Media Production, and you should be able to see my on-demand episodes. If you can't see my on-demand episodes, where you're getting your favorite podcast from, I always try to refer people to Spotify, iHeartRadio, and Apple iTunes, because these are the most popular platforms out there, and my shows are being carried on those platforms. Also on HDAradio.net, iWave Radio, MCCBroadcasting.com, IBCBroadcasting.com, YouTube, Turk TV Network is carrying my shows on YouTube, and just type in their acapella radio, you should be able to see my shows. And just go to my YouTube channel, and you'll see my shows on my YouTube channel, Stevie R. Butler, a.k.a. Stevie B. You should be able to see my on-demand episodes. And also, you can pull these shows up on World of Acapella and also on Deezer, and coming soon to Pandora as well. Also, I want to give a shout-out to my sponsors who are sponsoring these radio shows, Sharon Norwood from Chicago, Illinois, Bethesda Memorial, Trinidad Directory Crematory Services, Stanley Phillips from Little Rock, Arkansas, Diversified Financial Network, LLC from Dallas, Texas, the owners Mark and Charlotte Carroll, and Cheryl Marat from Charlotte, North Carolina, Yvonne Blazing Cracker Gooch from Nashville, Tennessee, Melvin Jackson from High Point, North Carolina, and Stephanie Booker Wilson from Greensboro, North Carolina. And I want to give the three E's. That's what I was going to say, the three E's of Stevie B's Media Production. It is the objective of this broadcast. We want to educate, we want to edify, and we want to encourage you in a study of God's Word. Now, let's get back to the show. You're listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
It's time for my funny bones. You know I love those comedians because laughter is good for the soul.
I love doing comedy. I was doing a show in Hermosa Beach at the Comedy Magic Club, right? So I leave, and I'm walking to my car, and it's getting a little cold, a little dark outside. So I'm thinking, let me hurry up to get to where I need to be. So I start jogging. Then this white lady with a little jogging outfit on came around the corner about 20 feet in front of me. We jogging in the same direction now. Then she looked back. She started jogging faster. So I look back too. I didn't see anything back there. If a white person is scared of it, Michael Jr. is scared of it too. Well, I started jogging faster. After she looked back again, she took off in full stride. This time, I didn't even look back. I also kicked in the gears. I could have easily passed her up. I'm thinking, no, I can't just lead a defenseless lady out here by herself. Whoever back there is going to get her. So I yelled up to her, is that as fast as you can run? I got to run too, I'm Michael Jr.
Yes, you've been listening to my funny bone. Because laughter is good, still good, for the soul.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
This your boy Lil Lou from Athens, Alabama, and these are records. Giving a shout out to my man Stevie B with the Acapella Gospel Music Blast. Every Friday night we get down just like this. These are records, baby.
Friday night, to keep the mood just right. Stevie B's on the radio. We're gonna play tonight. If you just tune in.
Gentlemen, I hope you're enjoying the flight tonight on the blast. I'm playing some of the world's greatest acapella gospel music artists, the sweet sounds of voices. We're flying 30,000 feet, and I'm dropping bombs everywhere.
In the mix with Stevie B, the Blaster Master of Acapella Gospel Music.
Hi, how are you? I'm not available right now, but if you leave your contact information and a brief message.
Well, we didn't get an answer on that call. Ladies and gentlemen, let me see. No, we didn't get an answer. Let me go ahead and do my, I got time for one more single that I want to play on the broadcast. This will be my old 100, and it's by the Most City Singers from Missouri City, Texas. God is able. You're going to love this song. Enjoy this single play, The Most City Singers. You got Stevie B. This is my old 100s. Stevie B on the ones and twos.
God is so.
while you still got some
out there with the United States Air Force, and he lives in Fort Irwin, California. Winston was heading up those prayers for me during my illness, and I certainly appreciate Winston S. Chambers. Stevie B wants to give you a shout out.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hello, everyone. This is Sebrum Branch, a solo artist and also a member of the North Mississippi Acapella Chorus. You're now listening to Stevie B's Music Blast, acapella style. Enjoy.
Hello, this is Mike Dow from Called by God Acapella Ensemble, all the way from Nashville, Tennessee. And you, yes you, can hear our singles Get Behind Me, Satan, and Brighter Day right here on Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Hey, this is John Poo Malone, and you're listening to the Acapella Gospel Music Blast with Stevie B.
It's your favorite DJ, Stevie B, the Blaster Master of Acapella Gospel Music.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for me to bring this big iron bird on down to the ground according to the clock on the wall. I have really... let me bring my bird down first, don't I? Yeah, I do need to bring the bird down. I just said I was going to bring it down. Now we got this big iron bird on down to the ground. This is the part of the show where I have to say goodnight, ladies and gentlemen. I really enjoy playing these inspirational songs and tickling your funny bones. I want to thank my special guest on the broadcast, the Soul Influence, Marcus Bottom and Monte Cuba. Really enjoyed chatting it up with those brothers from the Soul Influence. That was a great interview. I want to thank my listeners for riding with me on the blast tonight. You, ladies and gentlemen, you cannot deny what you hear on the blast on a Friday night. I'm playing the world's greatest acapella gospel music artist, the sweet sounds of voices. But I want to thank most of all the God of heaven through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for allowing me the privilege. And it is indeed a privilege to be able to spend this time with you on a Friday night. So until we meet again, may God continue to bless your lives. And may bless you real, real good. You've been listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.
Let me hit you with three pieces before I get up out of here. And peace. And I'll see you, Lord say so, on the other side. Good night, everybody. God bless you. You've been listening to Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast, episode 176.
Stevie B's Acapella Gospel Music Blast.